Welcome back to Gloved Up Garage. In this episode, I'm going to run through a couple of updates that we've got on the garage itself. And you can see the panel is in place now. Our electrician was out here yesterday. It's got the panel run, the conduit, and the two made feed lines in the neutral. Ground is outside in the ground, obviously. And they've run that cable there. They went ahead and dropped in one outlet so that we have that ready for the inspection. And then the orange cable on the bottom of that stringer that runs all the way to the back of the building, out the wall back there in the corner, that's where the compressor pad will be poured, and that's where I'm gonna run the compressor. So from, there's gonna be a box out there that it's a service disconnect like what you'd see for home AC. From that service disconnect, then I'll be able to run it up to the actual compressor through some conduit. So that'll come later. That'll be another video. I've got to buy about 8 more bags of concrete and then get some wood to form up that pad. And hopefully I can beat the cold weather and get all that complete before it gets cold outside. I don't know if I'll film that. It's going to be kind of strenuous and probably take me a couple of days to get everything done for that. So you can see I started moving the parts washer back here into the corner. I've got everything almost where I want it. Where the engine stand, that ladder and that rack is, that's where my drill press is gonna go. That's about where the parts washer is gonna be, is in that corner. And then over to the right of the parts washer, I'm gonna put my blast cabinet over there. Once I get that cart and all that other just random, all this random junk out of here and all this wood, of course. Front bumper for the police car, front fenders that I'm not gonna use, I've got those for sale on the marketplace, so that's always a joy. And then I've got the rear bumper for the police car sitting over there as well. Marauder still sitting here, and gotta get it inspected so that I can finally get a tag on it. Yeah, so not much of an update on the car. Haven't done any work to it this past week. After getting those headlights in, I need to start working on the door panels. That's what I'm trying to work towards, but I had to get this wall and the electrical stuff knocked out first. So in this video, I'll go ahead and start working on that door panel so I can show you guys what we're talking about. Walk around here to the other side of the car, get the door open, and show you what I mean about what we're gonna do. On most Crown Vics, every Marauder I've seen over age, you can see that armrest pad is kind of bulging out to kind of give you a side profile. It's really sticking out. And what some people have done is peeled this up, and you can see there's a plastic layer underneath of it. Under the vinyl, there is a foam, like a cellular foam. Basically, what I have to do is take this entire door panel apart off of the car, and then this pad is actually plastic welded in place. There are a couple of screws on the back side of this that hold it in place, but the pad itself is plastic welded in. And maybe at one point on the older Crown Vics, they were held in place with nothing but screws because the bosses that are plastic welded appear to be screw bosses. And for whatever reason, I guess Ford maybe decided to speed up the process of assembly by melting them instead of actually just running screws in. So once I get this apart, you'll see what I'm talking about. So to remove the door panel from a Crown Vic or Marauder, this might work for town cars. I've not taken one apart. The first thing you got to do is pop that little cover off. There's a screw underneath of it. There is one more screw down here at the end. And it seems like there was another screw up here in the front somewhere. Maybe not on this one. There's a screw underneath of this switch panel. And you have to be very careful popping this up. It's kind of got to pop up to the front and then be lifted out. Otherwise, you'll break the tab that goes right there. We'll have the same issue that we done on the driver's side where it kind of flops around. I'm going to grab some tools and go ahead and start popping this apart, show you what I'm talking about. All right, so I got that panel off. You can see there's the tab that holds it in place. This is another tab that attaches it in there. But this is the rear one that I'm talking about right here in the back. If you're not careful when you pop this up, it'll break off and then it won't hold this into the door panel. There's a 7mm screw that is hidden behind this. And then that one is actually a Torx bit, and I think it's like a T30 or T27, but I'll get to that in just a second. I knew I was missing a couple of screws. So this is on the bottom of the door panel. There's one in the front, one in the back. Those are 7mm, so I'll get those out real quick. So those bottom screws are out. The screw behind The handle is out. The handle actually pops out. That screws out. One on the end is out. Of course, the two at the bottom. So to get this panel off, take this little corner piece off too. It should just pop off. Try really hard not to break it because it is kind of loose. There it goes. And it's just held in with a little metal clip and plastic tab. All right. Now to get this off, you kind of lift up on it. And there you go. It's loose. So I'll grab it and lift it off of there. There's a module on the back for the seat that has to be unplugged. And then it'll come free from there. So this would be the perfect time to change out speakers if you were going to do a door speaker upgrade. For now, I'm not going to, so that will just stay in there. This is the back side of the panel. And the area that we're interested in is right in here, behind that bracket. That is where the armrest is. You have to move this insulation aside. And you can see right there is one of the plastic welds. Holds that insulation in place. There's another one up here. Basically, they just take like a really large soldering iron or something with a hot tip, melt that insulation into the plastic. So I will have to heat that up and get it loose so that I can get the insulation peeled back. This screw right here is one of them that we will need to take loose. This other screw behind the metal bracket or on top of the metal bracket is another one. And then from there, once we get the insulation out of the way and those screws out of the way, you'll see the tabs that I'm talking about that we're gonna have to melt. Basically what they look like right now is the same thing that are on that speaker grill. So here's what I'm gonna be using to repair this. I've got my Milwaukee portable soldering iron, battery powered. Got my torch here that I'll use to heat up this old screwdriver. You can see the tip of it's kind of bent up. I already got there was actually three screws holding the armrest onto the door panel. So I've got those three out with my little snap-on driver. And then the most important thing we're gonna be using is this epoxy. I'm actually gonna use 30-minute cure epoxy instead of like 5-minute. And the reason being is it gives you more working time to get this thing back into the groove that it sits in. And it gives you time to kind of wrap it around, and you'll see what I'm talking about. But I've got to use some clamps in order to clamp that outer portion back to the plastic portion underneath. So I'm going to start working on getting some of these like spots here that are melted down. And you can see what I'm talking about. This is what you would normally see like a screw go into, but for whatever reason, they decided to melt them. I don't know if that was original design, if this came after to speed up or whatever, but you know, that's one of the screws I took out, and then looking at it, it looks to be the same as the other ones. So I'm gonna start working on getting the insulation back out of the way so I can get to some of the other spots that I have to release the plastic on, and then I'll come right back. So to show you the technique that I'm using, these white areas here are the parts where the armrest is actually attached to the door panel. What I'm trying to do, you know, can see where I got the insulation loose on these two spots here, that one and that one. So you just kind of slowly work on the back side of the insulation where it meets the door panel with the soldering iron. You can tell this thing, it's hot, the light's green. What you want to do is you want to release this armrest from the door panel, but try not to damage too much of this plastic. Basically what I'm going to do is work this plastic up into like a you know, a pin, so it'll go back through that bracket. And same thing on the door panel, what I'm trying to do is work this plastic here into a smaller taller pin so that the door panel will release the armrest. And then same thing down in here, just kind of work these two areas, and then the last one would be right there. And then you can see there's a clip right there that kind of holds the armrest onto the door panel. Once we get all these areas melted free, then it'll just pop right up. So kind of show you what I'm going to do. Take my soldering iron here, and I'm just kind of going around the edge. And what I want to do is work that plastic back towards itself, basically unspreading it from
where it was spread out. But, you know, these things are just held in place with friction. In all technicalities, I could probably take a drill bit
or a Dremel tool and just buzz that like mushroom head of plastic off of there, and it would probably release and do the same thing. But I'm trying to keep some of the plastic on it so I have something to spread back out. If you had a plastic welder or something like that, you know, you may be able to just weld on like a new mushroom, a new spread out piece. You can see, I mean, I'm pushing it back, just a little bit of pressure, trying to get it to go back towards the middle. And then basically what I'll do is, once I'm done with this and it pops free and I repair it, I'll come back in here with the soldering iron and then spread that back out in the same manner that it was done from the factory. But so I'm gonna keep working at this thing, but you can see it takes a little bit of time. You know, this isn't something you're gonna do in just a couple of minutes. It, you know, you have to finesse it. You don't wanna get it too hot. And I'm working both sides of it, trying to get it to go back towards the center. So I'm gonna work on this a little bit more, and then I'll come back to you guys once I have this one done. All right, and once you get it worked back up, you can see that pin will release from the panel. You just keep going around the edge, pushing the plastic back up into like a, you know, a cone shape, a pyramid, a pin, whatever you want to call it. And then once it is up far enough, it'll release. So I've got to do this one, that one, that one, that one. This, basically all the ones in white. So there's five here, two on this bracket, and then in theory that should go ahead and release the armrest itself, because you can see the bottom side of it is that white plastic. I'm gonna work on these last six that I've got to do, and then I'll come back to you guys. So once you get all the little pins melted, you have to apply a little pressure, and then the armrest will pop out, and then this is what you've got. So you can see these are the pins that I've melted down that were going through the gray part of the door panel. These were the two up top. That's the clip I was talking about that kind of holds it into that metal bracket. And there's another smaller clip right there. Not really a clip, but just a ledge. So you can see it's bowed out. And what has happened and what causes this to happen? The foam that is under the armrest, the vinyl part of the armrest, becomes detached from this plastic liner. It's injection molded. You can see this is where they shot it in, filled it up in the cavity, and then they put the vinyl over top of it. And it should flip down over this lip. As you can see on this side, it's flipped down over. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to peel this back as far as I can peel it around the edges. When you're using that epoxy, you want to make sure you get a good adhesion. So what I'm going to have to do is take like some 320 grit sandpaper and get in there and sand the plastic side of this really, really good. Wipe it down with some alcohol so that there's no mold release or anything like that on it. And then I can go ahead and apply my epoxy down inside of here. So I'll mix it up, and then I'll put a bunch down inside of it. And you'll see when I mix it up, it's about the size of a half dollar or so. And I'll just stick that down inside of it with a piece of cardboard, or I'll find something around here to stick it in there with. But yeah, that's all you do. Fill that up full of epoxy, and then I'm gonna get some clamps, and I'll go around and I'll clamp this. And I'm also gonna put a really thin piece of plywood around the outside when I clamp it to spread out the load of the clamp so that you don't get portions or parts that are gonna be really tight, and then the next part in between the clamp is a little loose, and then tie it at the next clamp, and it keeps it from getting wavy, basically, is what I'm saying. You don't want this wavy, you want it to be straight. So I think I've only got like four or five clamps, and when I put this back together the first time, I noticed that there was quite a bit of space between the clamps, and I just grabbed a small piece of plywood to kind of fill up the area between and spread that load out. So I'm gonna pull this off and get to work on it, and then I'll come right back and show you where I've sanded it. All right, so I peeled that back, got in there with some, actually used 120 grit sandpaper, and it's kind of hard to tell, but
basically just scuffed the inside of that really good and along this lip. So I'm gonna wipe this down with some alcohol. I'll use one of these cheap brushes to mix up my epoxy. Got me a piece of cardboard here to mix the epoxy on. And then from there, I'll start to spread that epoxy in there. Now this is gonna take actually two steps. One will be the inner edge right inside here. Once that is set up, then you can go back and put some epoxy on this outer lip and then wrap the vinyl back over top of it. So it does take a couple of steps. I mean, this is not an easy process, but so far this is the most permanent process that I've found that works to repair these things and make them look like they should. So I'm gonna wipe this down, move on to the next step. So with the epoxy, basically you have the epoxy itself, then you have the hardener. And what you do is you obviously put the epoxy down. I've already done that. Drop the hardener into the middle of it, and then you just want to mix this up really good. Sometimes they're different colors, like JB Weld's a different color. What'll happen is this will start to cloud up as it mixes, and you can see it's going from like a clear to a cloudy as that chemical reaction takes place. But I'm gonna mix this up really good. And again, with this, it's 30 minute cure time. So it's, you know, some of these epoxies are like a 5 minute cure. You have to be really careful what you're doing. With this being 30 minutes, you've actually got some time to work this in there, and you've got some time to get your clamps on so you're not rushing and it's not trying to get hard or warm on you while you're trying to get this thing, you know, all positioned correctly. So I'll work on getting this mixed up, start getting it in there, and then I'll show you how I get the clamps on. All right, so I got my epoxy done in there, and you can't really see it, but you have to be careful when you're putting this in because the lip of this will try to grab some of the epoxy as it comes back over. I got a bunch right here, but I've already cleaned it off with the paper towel. So this is the point where you start to kind of put a little bit of pressure, and what you're hoping to do is that by clamping this down with the glue on the inside, it will glue the foam back to the plastic and keep it from having this kind of blowed out bowed look to it. What I'm gonna do, I found a paint stir stick, which will work perfect. You can see I'm gonna set it on there, and then I'll start to apply my clamps, and I'll have to move them around a little bit, but essentially I wanna clamp, you know, from this area to this area here and clamp this down so that it holds form. And what I mean about coming back later and doing the lip is when you're doing this, it's gonna squeeze a little bit of epoxy out onto this lip, but it's not gonna completely seal this lip and give it something to bite onto and hopefully keep from rolling back off in the future. So after this cures in about an hour, I'll come back and then I'll roll this lip up by hand, and I'll put a little bit more epoxy on this lip just to give it a little bit more bite. Hopefully that will keep it from, again, rolling up in the future. All right, so I've got all my clamps on, and you see what I mean about using that piece of wood to kind of apply some pressure. Get between the clamps here, you can see it's got a good uniform curve to it to kind of match the plastic piece underneath. I have to use a couple of C-clamps on it as well at the end there just to kind of hold it in place. I think I'm gonna grab one more C-clamp and get it right in between these two clamps too, just to make sure I get a good even pressure. That is the area where it bows out the most, you know, right in that area there. So I'll grab that clamp, and then from there I'm just gonna let this sit for an hour. Right now it's a little bit after 1 o'clock, so I'll come back after 2, take all my clamps off, and then mix up the next bit of epoxy to kind of seal this lip to the plastic liner itself. From there, once that cures, so another hour or so, I'll be able to put this back together this afternoon, put it back on the car, and I'll show you how to put it back together, kind of reverse of using the soldering iron to get those pins loose. Now I'm going to flatten them out, and I'll show you how I do that. So I'll come back once this thing's cured up and ready to go back on. So my clamps are off. I'm going to go through and just glue this lip down. I just want to keep it from pulling up any further. And when I do that, I'm going to use some of that masking tape to kind of hold the edge down. There's really no way to clamp from this side to the top. I don't have any clamps that are that wide, and I really don't want to put that much force on it. The masking tape will just kind of pull this back over the lip enough where the epoxy will set up. It looks better than it did. I don't know that there's a way to make these things 100% perfect, but it definitely will tuck into the door panel much better than what it was. It's at least holding its shape. You can see it's bowed out just a little bit, but again, it's definitely 100 times better than it was, and it'll make a noticeable difference when we get it back on the door panel. So I'm going to mix up the epoxy, and I'm going to glue down this lip here and use the masking tape to hold that down. And then I'll come back after I let this set up, and then we'll get that mounted back onto the door panel. So I put the masking tape on there just to kind of draw that edge back over, and it should set up pretty quick. I put a little bit more hardener in it this time than I normally do, just to kind of get it to set up a little faster. This step here, you probably don't need to use the 30-minute epoxy. You can get away with 5-minute epoxy on this. But I don't have any 5-minute right now. I've got the 30 out here. So for now, that's just going to work. I'm going to let that set up for a couple hours and then come back. Peeled all the tape off. Everything looks good. You can see there's a little bit of adhesive that's kind of sticking out there. But for the most part, it's in pretty good shape. I'm happy with it. You know, it's good and solid now, so I don't think we're going to have any issues with it peeling off. Hopefully this is a permanent fix and I won't ever have to do this again, but if I do, at least I know how to get it all back apart. So now I'm going to go ahead and put this back into the door panel, start melting down these pins and putting the screws back in it, and hopefully it'll go back in with no issues. I'll flip the door panel up and get it up here and start melting. And you can see what the door panel looks like with that armrest pad out of the way. And it just fits down in there, and you can see some of the holes. I enlarged a couple of these holes right here down at the bottom just to make it a little easier to get the armrest pad out. So now we'll get this thing snapped back in and start melting the plastic on the backside and get this thing done. One thing that makes it a little easier to get this back together, if you go ahead and put the screws back in, it kind of draws the door panel and the pad and the armrest pad back up together. Makes it much easier to start going through and melting these pins back down. I noticed as I was getting it tightened up, these pins popped into place. And then the clip up there at the front, of course, it's popped into place. That one right there, you can barely see it, but it's in there. These rear holes are lined up, and then these three at the top are lined up good. So what I'm going to do now is heat up my soldering iron and start melting these things out. And the idea here is, you know, we want it to look as close to the factory as it can. So I'll kind of work the plastic outward and then spread it around to make it wider. And then I'll kind of melt down the door panel, it's, you know, to match that too. Basically just kind of melt these two things together where they hold on to each other. Waiting for the soldering iron to warm up, and then I'll get to work. All right, so I got all those pins melted down. These two here melted. The three that are under here, the two under there, they're all melted. Kind of see it's not perfect, but it definitely holds. The insulation's back into place as well. I've melted down the little section of plastic that holds it into place. We'll go ahead and flip this up and you can see what the end result looks like. So it's better than it was. It's not perfect. It's definitely more solid. You don't have this thing kind of flopping around in the wind. The edge of the armrest pad is solid. It does squeak a little bit, but I mean, hey, it's a plastic door panel. It's not going to be perfect. Feel free to share this, guys. If you all know of any Crown Vic groups or Crown Vic guys that are having the same problem with their door panels, Grand Marquis, Marauders, all of them share the same door panels. And you know, I don't know that anybody else has done this. If they have, that's awesome. This is just the way that I decided to do it. It worked for my driver's side, and I had a lot of people asking me how I did it, so I decided to go ahead and do a video for you guys and show you how I did it. Feel free to hit the like button if you like the video. Leave me a comment if you found something worth commenting on. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification so that you are notified when I do upload new videos. This will be going up tonight. And for now on the Marauder, I don't have anything else to work on. I promised you guys I would get this done and get it out there. So for now, I'll just be doing some updates on the garage. I'll be doing a little bit of work on the Marauder. I'm gonna try to buff it out and get some of the scratches out of the hood.
make the paint look a little bit better. I've got some other compounds that I'm going to give a whirl and see what happens. So for now, thanks for tuning in. Catch you on the next one.